Bad or something?
I don't know.
Yeah, she'll probably stand you up.
Oh, no way.
Have fun.
I got myself out of a class for this, and she's not even gonna show up. You think a girl would come and meet you here on time? She's probably in my class. Actually, she probably went.
Well, you must not know her very well if you don't even know she's in your class.
Oh, come on. There must be like 750,000 people in that class or something. I mean, I wouldn't know if my mom was in there. What are you doing here?
I'm just waiting for a friend.
Well, I guess I can wait as long as you can wait.
Well, that's fair. Your buddy comes all the way down from Tacoma to see you, and you won't open the door to talk to him.
Please go away.
Come on, Brian. I gotta talk to you.
You know, Dave, I'm not gonna see you this time. And you know why?
Because every time I see you, Dave, you always give me the same speech about how I'm doing everything wrong by going to my college and you're doing everything right by going to yours.
Brian, it's not that I'm always doing everything right and you're always doing everything wrong. You always say that. Pass me the salt, will you? No, this would be pepper. Thank you. It's just that we have different ways of reaching our goals.
Uh-huh.
I mean, look, you've got to admit that MTI is a way better school than the one you're going to. The teacher-to-student ratio is better, the classes are tougher, and the social life is way more,
boring.
Yeah, thanks. Listen, MTI is a tough school. If you want to be competitive in the job market, you got to be going to a school like MTI. And it doesn't hurt to impress the employers with a little of the old prestige, if you know what I mean.
Dave, I only want to be a chemical engineer.
Buddy, you'd be surprised how many people want to clean water. Look, Brian, there's no question MTI is the right school for you. I think the question is, are you right for MTI? I know I am, Brian. I'm the perfect student for that school. I've got the certain quality of character that they need. I don't know if I'm to say, but I don't know if you fit in there, buddy. Friends. I love them.
Just gonna love this.
Brian, this is ridiculous. I've got to study.
You haven't seen these movies in years. You can study tomorrow.
Study tomorrow? My test is tomorrow.
I can't believe how long it's been since I've seen these people. I don't even remember half of them.
God, some of the girls weren't half bad looking, were they?
No, they weren't.
Whoa.
Oh, baby.
I remember her. God, you should have seen the girl I saw the other day, though.
She's pretty cute, huh?
She was really cute.
Where'd you see her?
Well, you know where I went down to meet that girl at the statue?
The one who never showed?
Right.
The one who left her bra under my pillow.
That's the one.
Yeah. Who was she?
I don't know. I never really asked her name or anything like that. I mean, it was really sort of a short encounter, but...
Sorority girl?
I think so. I mean, sort of that snooty, snotty attitude.
Yeah.
Kind of a drag, but she was gorgeous.
You'll probably never see her ever again in your life.
Yeah, probably not. You know, Fletch, I really should be studying for my econ test.
Yeah, all right. You want to go walking downtown with me tomorrow?
Walking downtown? Fletch, you're not getting the picture. Tomorrow I've got to take the test I'm supposed to be studying for tonight, and I've got to study for the test I'm going to take the next day. And you should be studying too. What's the problem? Oh, that's right. I forgot. Good grades grow on trees for you. Well, not for me, bud.
You're starting to sound like Dave.
Dave? What's wrong with Dave?
Nothing.
Nothing? You mean Dave's getting on you about your studying too, huh?
About my studying? Dave's been getting on me about my entire education.
Yeah, well, maybe somebody ought to. You're sort of sitting here wasting it away. It's expensive, you know.
All right, to be honest, I am having second thoughts about my education. I mean, I don't want to drop the whole thing, but... I don't see where the harm is in thinking about maybe finding a different alternative.
Well, isn't it costing you a lot of money to sit around looking for another alternative?
No, it's not costing me any money. It's costing my old man money.
And that's all right? Look, Brian, we both have things we should be doing.
So you don't want to go downtown with me?
Fletcher... Face the facts. Look, I'm gonna go study. You do what you want.
We'll be right back. Hello? Hi, Mom. I'm fine. How are you? How's Lisa? She did? Really? School's good. Is someone else on the line? Oh, hi, Dad. How are you? I got a C. C plus. Yeah, I tried. Look, if it means that much to you, just let me move home. I'll pay my own way. All right. I know I can't. Right. Just, why don't you just stay off my back? Right. Right. Right.
May I help you?
Yeah, I'd like these cleaned by Friday. Is there anything wrong?
No. So you've got some shirts here. You like those on hangers or folded? Light starch, medium
just
starch,
clean,
heavy?
Just clean, please.
You want to go out on a date?
No. When can I get these back?
Wednesday.
Okay, good.
Do you remember who I am at all? Or?
Yeah, did you ever meet your girlfriend?
Which one? I'm kidding. Hey, I'm kidding. Come on. What's the problem? First you don't want to go out with me, then you don't like my jokes? What sorority are you from?
Kappa Delta, right? The seat taken here? It's not. Look. I know of this party going on Wednesday night. Wait, let me guess. You study on Wednesday night, don't you? Well, by chance, I don't have a date. So, what do you say to Friday night? No?
You don't even know my name.
And Beth. He didn't even know.
Ann.
Lucy.
Second.
Lisa, right?
Why don't you just ask?
What is it?
Sarah.
Oh, Sarah.
Lisa, you can't even believe.
Why don't you just give me a break?
Why don't you give me a break? Whoever you are.
Jeff,
I have a lot of better things to do with my time than to sit around and wait for you to chase after me all the time and bug me. I could be studying. I've got midterms coming up. You don't even seem to understand that I have to study. I bet you've never studied before in your life.
Look, Dad, I'm getting A's. Don't give me that. I'm sure there's plenty of other top-of-the-line engineering schools in the country I could be going to. And I'm sure you would have known someone on the faculty of one of those. You know, there's other things I could do. Like be a writer.
Yeah, a writer. Well, then maybe I should pay for him myself. I don't even know if I want to be going to school. I really don't. And besides, what makes you think I need to stay near home? What? Laundry. Dad, if it comes down to that, I'll clean my laundry in the sink.
Like you really struck out with this girl.
Yeah.
What'd she say to you?
Well, she told me that she's never met anybody like me in her life and that she never wants to ever again. That was about the gist of it.
Well, at least you got her to talk to you. The love I had in college, at least the one I wanted to have in college, did not even know I existed. Boy, I was always at the right place at the right time with the right smile.
Really?
No good.
No good. You know, with this girl, I really think it's sort of, well, I guess it's my attitude about myself and just the way I look at things. And I see myself as Jeff McKay, going to school and graduating with honors, getting myself a 2-car garage, the whole thing.
Sounds like school is important to you.
Well, it's gotta be. Gotta get my diploma. Think.
You think? You think that's the only way you can succeed?
I'm starting to sound like Brian is what I think.
What is it you want?
I don't know, Mom. I'm only a freshman. How am I supposed to know that?
I think you have some idea of some of the things that you want.
Yeah.
Most of all, you want a diploma and you want to get on with your life.
Oh, I can't go anywhere without it, Mom. Gotta have a plan.
Remember, you don't have to have the same plan as everyone else.
Yeah, well, I'm not just gonna run out on the freeway and hitchhike to New York.
Take a load off, Patty. Take a load for free. Put the load right on me. Crazy Chester followed me and he caught me in the fall. He said, I will fix your rat if you take Jack my dog. I said, wait a minute, Chester. No, I'm a feeble man. That's okay, boy. Won't you feed him when you can? Yeah, take a load off, Fanny. Take a load for free.
Whatever it is you choose, I'm going to love you anyway.
Well, I love you too, Mom. I'd love it if you'd just keep rubbing my back.
That's not going to get your college degree.
No, but I'm going to feel real good when it's over. Which is better than I was doing earlier. You're studying.
What do you think? Good grades grow on trees? Come on. Here, read this.
What is it?
It's a script I was working on.
Really? This is really good. Since when do you write plays?
Since about a year and a half ago.
I hope you don't mind my asking, but what are you doing here?
I don't know. Has to do with love and respect, I guess.
Be a father? For yourself. Thank you.
clouds. I looked at life that way. But now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads. They say I've changed. Well, something's lost, but something.